is Bishop Garland Hunt, and this is the Power of Hope Devotional. Hey, thank you for joining me. I thank you, those that have been following for quite a while. Be sure sometimes to make a comment to let me know that you're there. I appreciate it so much. It just encouraged me to let me know that you're blessed by this ministry. Let me ask you a question, though, today. In the Power of Hope today, I want to ask you this question. Are you ready for your reward? Are you ready for your reward for how you live on this earth? This is a very serious question. I was actually, unfortunately, I had to do a eulogy for somebody very, very close to me. And so, you know, we talked a lot about the accolades of the person, how great he was, and there's no doubt about the fact that he was born again. There was no doubt about it. And everybody, including his sons, his family, his friends, all of us recognized that he was going to be with the Lord. But when I came up to do the eulogy, I had to ask the question, are you ready for your reward? Because you're going to either go before the great white throne judgment as a sinner or as a believer, which I wanted to believe that most of them were. Are you ready for the rewards of what you've done in this body? And the scripture I want to tell to you is actually 2 Corinthians chapter 5. And here it says, verse 7. Can I read that for you? Can you follow me? It says, for we live but believing, not but by seeing. For yet we are fully confident we would rather be, listen to this, away from these earthly bodies. So for then we'll be at home with the Lord. If we're away from these earthly bodies, we have the confidence that we'll be with the Lord. And it says, so whether we are in this body or away from this body, our goal is to please him. See, this is our goal. Whether we're in the body or away from the body, our goal is for him to say, that good and faithful servant, first servant, come. Because he sees your faithfulness. He sees your consistency. He sees your determination. He sees how you're going through things biblically, how you don't waver on the word. He sees that. So you have that kind of confidence to know that God himself is seeing you. So therefore, if I'm in the body or not, I know that I'm pleasing him. But then it goes on further, and this is where it gets juicy. It says, for we must all stand before Christ to be judged. So this is not just a sinner that's going to stand. These are even Christians, particularly in this case, before Christ. The sinners go before God in the great white throne judgment, which everybody gets the same punishment, which is damnation, eternal fire. But at least the Christians have an opportunity to go before Christ, but they're still going to be judged what you've done in this body. And then let me go further. It says, for we must all stand before Christ to be judged. We will each receive whatever we deserve for the good or evil we have done in this earthly body. We get what we deserve. See, what we've done in this body, the good or the evil that we've done in this body, that we get what we deserve then before the good judgment seat of Christ. That's right. So understand this. It's not over even when you leave this earth. And I know that many times we say, oh man, it's so good to be with the Lord. And it's going to be great to be with the Lord. It's going to be so much better to be with the Lord than it is on this earth. No doubt about it. There's no question. It's not even could be compared. There are people that have felt that they've died and they've gone and seen a vision of heaven and then they came back to their bodies. Listen, most of them did not want to come back. They recognized the power and the beauty of heaven. But even in that, at some point, we still will have to come before him and he will judge us based on what we have done in this body. So these bodies are important. What we've done on this earth and in our lifetime. Well, and you heard a lifetime achievement? What's been a lifetime achievement before the Lord? I mean, this thing is serious. I'm telling you right now, I want you to recognize how important it is to have a fear of the Lord and recognize what we do, we will have to account for it. Even what we think, even the things we say, all these things will be rehearsed before the Lord when we go before him. So listen, I want you all to say, count the cost. The things that you do, no, we have the answer for them later. This is Bishop Garland Hunt. This is the Power of Hope Devotional. Are you ready for your reward?